Grayslake has a population of 21,000 people, and they have tornado sirens that they test every first Tuesday of the month. From June 30th to July 2nd, 1938, 5 to 7 inches fell from a cloudburst. It overflowed the lake and its banks and flooded the park, which was under 4 feet of water after a couple of hours. Lake Street at the Vintage Market was under 12 inches of water. Route 20 and 54 were underwater from High's Corner to Center Street was underwater. Route 54 was entirely submerged at the SOO line tracks. People would fish in the street, and it caused at least $1 million in damage.
The next natural disaster was the tornado of August 2015, which affected many people in Grayslake, including someone named Cody Lester.
All right, so how was your family affected by the tornado?
Well, we were affected by the tornado because my trampoline was thrown up against my house, completely cracking the side of my house that it hit. And, yeah, we had to get that fixed. And we ended up helping a bunch of people in our neighborhood.
Where were you when it started, and how did you react?
I was up in my room on the second floor, and I heard the trampoline hit the side of the house, and wind started coming in. So I bolted downstairs and got in my basement as fast as I could.
What did your family do after the tornado?
We went out, we brought some chainsaws home from the shop, and a couple of my cousins and my close family went out around my neighborhood, like cutting the trees out of people's yards and just helping them, making sure they were all right and everything.
Was there any serious damage done to the area around you?
Yeah, the tornado was like right over our house, and like people's sidings were ripped off. My house got pretty messed up. There was like a hole in my backyard, or there was a hole in the back of my house, and like I said, the whole corner of my house was broken in. But like most people got like their shingles ripped off and their gutters ripped off. I guess it wasn't major damage, but it was definitely some substantial damage.
Who was there with you when it happened, and what did they do after the tornado?
After the tornado had went by, we went outside to make sure everybody was all right, like at night, and I guess close neighbors.
Was an EF1 tornado that cost Central High School $350,000 to repair the band roof, which flew into the choir teacher's front yard.
The EF1 tornado was underground for 15 minutes and it reached for 7.5 miles underground, which ran through Round Lake, Grayslake, and Wildwood.
Many houses were damaged and parts of the skate park were moved around. Trees and power lines were knocked down. There was some damage, and we believe the flood affected Grayslake the most. A lot of buildings were knocked down, and it was just hard for the Grayslake Fire Department to pump water out of people's houses. So there was lots of damages, lots of flooding. Just overall, probably one of the worst disasters in Grayslake history.